Good morning.
Babes, I don't have paper either. Sorry.
So I couldn't find paper, documents. So we're done with our rounds, and my team is in clinic today, so I'm off to clinic to join them. My book, I want to keep records of everything. Say hi to my hospital bestie. You're going to be on YouTube.
Yay!
This one went to collect samples. Taking it to the lab. Oh my god!
That's what we are here for.
I'm hungry. Which? That's actually fact. Why are you the one taking the sample to the lab? What happened to the HA?
The thing is, I actually want to push for you. That's why.
Oh, such a caring doctor. Are you serious? Has been crazy. I'm fresh off my leave and I came back to 11 patients, like ridiculous, honestly. And then my team had clinic today, so we just finished that. We only saw about 12 or 13 patients. I have to keep records of everyone we see, so I had to go over the computers and look at the diagnosis and everything and then write it down on the book. I also have to shuffle between two rooms because some of my chiefs are here and some are in the other one, so that's what that's about. Now I'm about to go back to the ward and do like my post rounds. I think I have one blood sample to collect and that's it. Oh no, I have one patient to discharge as well, and yeah, that should be it. I'm on call today. I don't know how that's gonna work. My period just came and I'm feeling real shitty right now, but you guys pray for me. So it's past 3 o'clock now. It's like 10 minutes past three. I'm done with all of my work. We're done from clinic. I had one patient to discharge and I discharged the patient already. I had like some samples to collect from one patient for a test we needed to run. I did that already. I just went out to, well, not out, there's a shop like very close to the quarters for doctors. So I went to get some tissue and I also got some water. I got extra though for my call hours just so I have enough water to drink. I also just ordered some food because I haven't eaten. Well, that's a lie. I had a meat pie because I was getting really hungry and I wanted to take pain meds because cramps are really killing me. But I just ordered proper food and hopefully it gets here soon. But you guys, this is actually going to be my last call in pediatrics and I'm so freaking excited. I can't believe peds is over. Pediatrics has been a madness. I leave on Thursday, hopefully, and today is Monday. So I really just have 3 more days. I just have to tough it out. And yeah, this is my last call. I'm so excited. I really wanted to vlog because I haven't vlogged my time in peds. I've actually enjoyed it at the same time as not enjoyed it. So yeah, I guess I just wanted to have something documented for pediatrics. I'm going to be on call for 32 hours, which means I don't leave work till 4 p.m. tomorrow. I came in at 8 o'clock this morning. So yeah, you guys pray for me that I have a calm call. I'm about to move all of my stuff into the call room. We usually do something called handover by like 3:30. Like the team in EPU will hand over to those of us on call. Just like let us know which patients are like really bad or those that need like close monitoring and all of that kind of stuff. It's almost 3:15 now. I'm gonna head into the call room and just chill for a bit and I'll catch you guys later. My call hours have officially begun and I just got called upstairs. Say her line is bad. Your line. It's at spot, Abby.
I don't know, she's not setting. If they are giving it, she will cry seriously.
It's almost 8 o'clock at this point. I take a walk because I really needed air. Like, I just needed to clear my head. So I took a walk with one of my colleagues and I just got back to the call room. Things happening right now. We don't have any patients or any admissions yet. So I'm just going to try to rest and save my strength in case anything crazy happens, but I'm really hoping that nothing does. I'm praying for a super calm call. I'm just going to chill, watch some stuff on my phone, edit some pictures, like do some of my personal work. And yeah, this is what call life is like. You literally just wait until you're called on. I guess that's why they say on call. But yeah, I'm so tired. I have to take a child for an MRI. I already got the diazepam, but the child doesn't have a line, so I have to go site an IV line and then we can go. I'm looking for the hospital assistant so that we can go. I was actually here earlier, but she stepped out and she's the one that's supposed to take the child with me. So I just hope she's back so that we can get going. I cannot believe it's past 10 p.m. already. I was supposed to take that child for MRI. I ended up setting a bunch of IV lines on the ward and now it's almost 10:20. For an MRI. The HA came a while ago and told us that the MRI was going to bring the child. The mother will be very... Because they've already not fed the child throughout today. Listen to you now. I'm just asking if it's possible for us to please do it today. We've been waiting for this MRI since the first. I don't even understand what the hell is going on. They're the ones who told us to go and bring the child. Now they're saying tomorrow. I need to drink water. I'm thirsty as hell. My MRI did not happen and I'm really pissed about that. And I just got back to PEDS now and I just heard there's a new patient in the consulting room. My back is killing me. I'm so tired. Oh, this water was so necessary. I don't know if to be happy or sad right now, but two patients just came to the consulting room. And typically what we do is like, we just see like if the child needs to be admitted or if it's just like outpatient, we prescribe medication and send them home. One of the kids that just came actually needs to be admitted and I had to go like inform the nurse. And guess what, you guys? The ward is completely full. They cannot take any more babies, so we literally have to send them away. Like, they have to go to another hospital. This means that we cannot admit any babies on our call. I kind of feel bad because that baby really needs like medical attention and I really hope that they're able to go somewhere else where the child will get good care. But it's just unfortunate that our ward is full. There's nothing we can do. Hopefully this is the end. Oh my god, it's past 12. We just sent the last outpatient home. I just hope nobody else comes because I'm asleep in the morning. So I just freshened up, like I washed my face and stuff. And also my scrubs aren't so dirty. I was going to change into something else, but my scrubs aren't so dirty. So I think I'll just wear them again today. Really hope I have a chill day because I'm still going to be here till 4 o'clock and we have consultant rounds with like 10 or 11 patients. So I'm about to hurry up so I can go start writing my summaries and all of that stuff before rounds start. So freaking tired. I'm hungry. I'm hypoglycemic. It's almost 1:30 and we're just now finishing our rounds. 10, I'll be 12 patients. I don't even know. Consultant rounds, like that always drags. Oh, I just want to go and eat. I'm so tired and I still have post rounds to do. And there's nothing, is there ever anything to eat in this hospital? I'm so tired. I want to cry. And I was on call yesterday. My legs are killing me. My back is killing me. My call wasn't stressful, but doing rounds and everything till 1:30, standing the whole time. I've been standing since 8 a.m. this morning, you understand? On call yesterday is just ridiculous, honestly. Tired. Thank you. food is here, food is here. Omo. I'm not even doing my first rounds, but I need to go and eat. A girl is hungry. It's almost 4 o'clock and I haven't eaten. This is going to be my first meal of the day. Hilarious.
I don't even know what's going on today, but it's past four and I'm still here. Yeah, I've got to eat here because I can't feed myself. My chips are struggling with one child's line, that's just really hard. And I can't deal anymore. I have to go and eat my food before I die. I just ate. Past 5 o'clock and I am dying. Like, I've been on my feet all freaking day. At this point, I need a freaking foot massage or something. I just want to put my shit in my car and go.
I'm tired. Like, this is one of the first times I'm proper sitting down all day.
This has been one of the busiest calls. Like, the call itself was not busy, but post-call has been very busy. Oh my god, this pimple is so irritating. We had, I think, 11 patients to see today or 12. We discharged 3. I was still going to get 3 back tomorrow because EPU admitted some patients for us in the morning yesterday. So we're back to the same patient load by tomorrow. I'm so freaking tired. After our rounds, we had like post rounds to do. And one of the post rounds was to cite a line for a baby. Actually, we had 2 lines to cite. I did the first one. The second one, the means that that girl, I knew I was not citing that line. Her veins were, I could literally not see anything. And they had tried to cite lines for her literally all over her body. Like they had poked her every single way. So I just went to call my chief, like, I cannot do this. Even the registrar couldn't get it. Like, she had to go call the senior red. That's how bad it was. We had another patient for chemo who was also having some issues we had to sort out. And then while we were there, one of our other patients who is also for chemo showed up to the hospital because she's supposed to have her chemo tomorrow. So she came today for her like hyperhydration and everything. We had to get on that as well, admitting her, taking samples, signing lines and all of that, you guys, all after our call. And I don't know if anybody realizes this, but I'm at the bottom of the chain, so I tend to do the most physical work. Like, I'm the one who's walking around, I'm the one who's looking for shit, I'm the one who's doing stuff. Not every call gets to the people on top, so I'm the one who's the most tired, if you ask me. Too happy because this is my last call in pediatrics, and wow. I love pediatrics, it has my heart, so grateful to be done. I don't even know what this vlog is going to look like. I just tried to get clips here and there. There's so many things I wanted to show you guys that I didn't even have the time to actually do. Like, I want to take you guys to neonatal. Neonatal was my favorite part of pediatrics. I rotated there for a whole month. I don't know why I never vlogged. I'm just about to go home. I'm really tired. I'm gonna go home, take a really nice shower and just chill the rest of the day. Because tomorrow morning, I'm back to this freaking job again by 8 o'clock. Like, it doesn't stop. It doesn't stop. It's 5 o'clock. I've been at work for 33 hours now. Please tell your kids not to be doctors. That's the only advice I have for you people. Don't do it. It's not worth it. I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. Take what you will out of it. I'm gonna drive myself home. My legs are literally shaking from being so freaking tired. Like, I need a massage ASAP. Hopefully I see you guys in my next video. I don't know if I'll make another vlog like showing my work and stuff, but if you guys would like to see more like vlogs when I'm at work, more work related stuff, if you have like ideas as well, because I don't think I can be vlogging every time. It's not very realistic. It's very hard to do truly in between my work. So if you guys have more like ideas on videos I can do concerning my work and everything, or if you want like a Q&A, you want to ask me questions, just let me know all of that in the comments. Please don't forget to like this video, and if you haven't subscribed, please subscribe to my channel. Yeah, I really hope you guys enjoyed this. I'll see you in my next one. Bye.